If you're thinking about getting the Echo Flask, or you're just curious if hydrogen water bottles really work, this video is for you. There's a lot of hype out there, and as someone with a strong background in health studies, before any purchase I always go and check the science. I prefer cold, hard facts over hype. So today I'm going to walk you through what you can actually expect, backed by real lab testing, not just opinions. Because when it comes to your health, data matters more than marketing, and that's the approach I take. So let's get started with what's inside the Echo Flask. The Echo Flask is a portable hydrogen water generator, pretty simple on the surface. It's built to infuse pure molecular hydrogen, or H2, into your drinking water, without altering pH levels dramatically or adding unwanted substances. The promise is clean water, supercharged with dissolved hydrogen for daily hydration and potential antioxidant benefits. But does it really do that? Let's jump into the hard evidence. Dissolved hydrogen levels tested in lab. First thing tested, how much hydrogen does the Echo Flask really generate? Here's what lab testing found using a gas chromatograph, a highly accurate instrument that measures dissolved hydrogen directly from the water sample. After a 10-minute cycle, approximately 6.07 milligrams per liter of dissolved hydrogen, about 6 parts per million, or ppm. After a 20-minute cycle, approximately 8.25 milligrams per liter dissolved hydrogen, about 8 parts per million. Those numbers are the average of 3 tests each, so pretty solid data. Essentially, in a full bottle, approximately 350 milliliters of water, a 10-minute run gives you roughly 2.1 milligrams of hydrogen gas in total, while a 20-minute run gives about 2.9 milligrams. So doubling the time doesn't double the concentration, but it does boost it a bit. I appreciated that the lab also noted the consistency. The 10-minute run was very consistent, only plus or minus 0.06 variance. And the 20-minute had a small variance, plus or minus 0.4. To keep it super simple, more hydrogen plus more time gives you higher concentration of hydrogen, but with diminishing returns after a certain point. These numbers are very strong compared to average hydrogen generators. For context, most studies on hydrogen therapy show noticeable benefits starting around 1 to 2 parts per million. The Echo Flask delivering 6 to 8 parts per million means you're getting a highly saturated hydrogen water with each cycle. Quick science check. What does ppm mean? Parts per million is just a way of measuring concentration. In water, 1 ppm means 1 tiny part of something per million parts of water. So if your bottle has 8 parts per million of hydrogen, that's 8 tiny parts of H2 dissolved evenly in the water. It's enough to make a real difference if you drink it shortly after production. Echo Water says that the hydrogen will stay infused up to 10 hours after the infusion, but hydrogen is incredibly light and loves to escape, so fresh-made hydrogen water is always best. I personally run the cycle and drink it right away after it finishes. Water safety? Are there contaminants? Another important question, does the Echo Flask add anything weird or unsafe to the water? Short answer, no. Lab analysis looked for all the common troublemakers. Chlorine? None detected. Heavy metals like lead or arsenic? None detected. Fluoride, nitrates, nitrites? None detected. Microbial contaminants? None detected. Basically, the water coming out of the Echo Flask is just clean, hydrogen-enriched water, nothing else. That's a big deal because some cheaper hydrogen devices that don't separate gases properly can create unwanted byproducts like chlorine gas. The Echo Flask is designed to avoid that, and the data proves it. What about oxidation reduction potential? You might have heard about ORP when it comes to hydrogen water. It stands for oxidation reduction potential, which basically measures whether water has oxidizing or reducing properties. Fresh hydrogen water tends to have a strong negative ORP, usually between negative 200 to negative 500 millivolts. Negative is good, it means the water may help reduce oxidative stress. So, what is oxidative stress? It's what happens when there's an imbalance between free radicals, which are unstable molecules that can damage your cells, and antioxidants, which are the molecules that neutralize them. Think of free radicals like sparks flying around inside your body. Too many sparks, and eventually something gets burned, your cells, DNA, or tissues. Antioxidants are like fire extinguishers, keeping those sparks under control. Over time, oxidative stress has been linked to inflammation, fatigue, slower recovery, and even chronic diseases like heart problems, diabetes, or cancer. That's why antioxidants, including hydrogen gas from hydrogen water, are being studied and used to support better health. And based on quick checks with a handheld meter, it usually reads around negative 400 to negative 500 millivolts. Just keep in mind, the real benefit comes from the hydrogen itself, not just the ORP number. Monitoring hydration results. As I told you before, I value real data and firsthand real results instead of a random guy with no evidence and no idea of what he is talking about. In addition to the lab tests, I've been tracking my hydration levels using my smart scale. I use the Hume Health Body Pod daily to monitor my health data. It provides a wide range of body metrics, including hydration. After several months of consistent use, the results are clear. My hydration levels have improved. Battery life. You can get roughly 10 cycles on a full charge. Since a double cycle only adds about 2 parts per million more hydrogen, I personally prefer to do single cycles and drink more water, rather than obsess over squeezing out the highest concentration every time. Also, keep in mind, battery life is affected by the number of full charge-discharge cycles, so running more single cycles can help preserve long-term performance, and you still get benefits from the hydrogen water. That's just my approach, but it's totally up to you and your own preferences. The Echo Water app. The Echo Flask pairs with the Echo Water app via Bluetooth, and it adds a useful layer of tracking to your routine. You can monitor your hydrogen cycles, set hydration goals, and even join challenges with friends. Just make sure your Bluetooth is connected and the app is up to date. I had a few issues in the beginning where some cycles didn't sync properly and weren't recorded, but after updating the app, everything started working perfectly. For me, the app became a really helpful tool for building better hydration habits. Just having visibility on how much water you're drinking each day creates awareness, and that alone can push you toward healthier routines. I will give you some simple principles of psychology behind it. Self-monitoring. Simply tracking a behavior, like water intake, increases awareness, which naturally leads to behavioral change. Hawthorne effect. When you know you're being observed, even by yourself, you're more likely to improve the behavior. Habit loop activation. The app acts as a cue, and the daily tracking creates a routine, leading to a reward. So to resume, visibility equals awareness. Awareness leads to behavior change. And through repetition, you create a habit. Common questions answered. Before I wrap up this video, I want to answer some common questions I've received over the past 2 months. You might have the same questions in mind, and a quick, straight-to-the-point answer could be exactly what you need. Can you use any kind of water? You can use purified, filtered, reverse osmosis, or distilled water. I recommend distilled or RO water to get the cleanest results. If you use tap water, it works also, but you will have to run a cleaning cycle more often to avoid mineral buildup at the membrane. How long does the hydrogen stay in the water? Hydrogen gas is tiny and escapes easily. Echo water claims you can drink the water within 10 hours after a cycle. Best to drink the water within 30 to 60 minutes after production for full potency. Does it smell weird? No. There's no chlorine, ozone, or chemical smell thanks to the membrane separation. How durable is it? Very solid. No leaks, no cracks. Feels like a premium device. Final thoughts. Here's my honest take. The Echo Flask does exactly what it promises. It infuses a high amount of pure hydrogen into the water, giving you the full benefits of hydrogen-rich hydration. It keeps the water clean, with no contaminants detected in lab tests. It's easy to use, safe, durable, and feels like a premium device. The app is a fantastic tool that genuinely helped me build better hydration habits. This isn't a magic pill, you won't turn into a superhero after one drink. But if you're serious about improving your hydration and naturally supporting your antioxidant defenses, the Echo Flask is a solid, science-backed tool to have in your daily routine. I personally use it throughout the day, especially after workouts. It helps with my recovery, and now that I've seen the lab results for myself, I trust it even more. If you want to get the Echo Flask with a special discount, just click the link in the description below. You'll be redirected to the official website, and the discount is automatically applied at checkout. Thanks for watching, and stay hydrated.